on the previous episode.
Yes, love being inside of a tree.
And now, continued.
Hello ladies and gentlemen, this is Best and Slot, and we are back playing Jurassic World Operation Genesis, because that's what it pretty much is. Now there's something I want to address super quickly at the start of the video, because lots of people have been commenting about it and it's been like a big thing. Obviously we've had some problems with dinosaurs collapsing and vanishing and being all... Do I need this? It's hard to tell. I'm going to extract it anyway. Dinosaurs fainting more than anything else has been the primary problem. And a lot of people have suggested that I'm doing something wrong. It's either been, oh, there's too many dinosaurs, or the exhibits are a weird shape, or the dinosaurs have different species, or they don't have enough food. And I'm just going to put this out there right now. You are all wrong. I'm sorry. It's just the way it is. It's a bug. I've not had this problem with any other series. It's clearly just an issue. Like, the fact that I've got carnivores who are on their own collapsing, who have a food thing just for themselves, even the Dimorphodons, right? Admittedly, there was maybe too many Dimorphodons at the start, although they are a small carnivore, not a large carnivore. Maybe there was too many Dimorphodons at the start. However, even when there's two Dimorphodons left, and there's a feeder for them, and there's plenty of goats running about, they still died. You know, they all just died. It wasn't a thing. It was just the Dimorphodons are a little bit buggy, so he died. And I... Oh, no, see, why is Echo dead? Why is Echo dead? Malnutrition. See, right, I'm going to get rubbish for that, right? But if we have a look, there's a goat right there, there's a goat right there, there's a goat right there, and there's water right there. So, I don't accept what any of you are saying. I really don't, because you're wrong. And usually, I'd shut up and just take it, but I've had so many comments that I really have to address it. And trust... Guys, this is like the fifth... Probably like the 15th time in my entire life I've played through this game. The fifth time I played it on the channel, I do have some semblance of an idea of what's going on and how the game functions. And I know what to expect by now. And it bugs me that people are giving me rubbish when they are incorrect, basically. And I appreciate, I know people are trying to help, and I don't want to sound bitter about that or unthankful, because I do appreciate all the comments, always. But I wish people didn't comment when they don't actually know the answer. If they're doing it in an accusatory tone. You know, sometimes it's like, Best and Slot, you're a fool, you're an idiot. What are you doing? No wonder they all died. Like, saying it, like, just, no, shut up, no, wrong. Most of you are being lovely, as per usual. Just want to add that at the end. Make sure you're Camphosaurus, right, there we go, lovely jubbly. I just want to get that out of the way. We're clearing the air, folks. We're clearing the air. We're going to get on. We're a good little bunch here. And 99% of the comments were fantastically helpful and lovely, as always. But just trust me when I say... The dinosaurs are fine. You know, they've all got food. Mixing species doesn't do anything. That's not a thing in this game. The small dinosaurs get freaked out with some of the bigger ones, but, you know, we've seen issues. Like, I've mixed, like, 20 species of dinosaur before, and sometimes it's okay. It really depends what you're mixing together. And there are no small dinosaurs mixed in with big dinosaurs anyways, anywhere in the park. Over here... I suppose Kentrosaurus counts as small, but these aren't like big, big dinosaurs. These are little big dinosaurs. These are medium dinosaurs. And the Kentrosauruses have been A-okay. They've not had any problems anyway. Just basically, there isn't actually a problem with what I'm doing. I just want you guys to trust me. Trust that I know. I spared no expense, I promise you. With that out of the way, I'm not going to buy that. That's crazy talk. I don't think there's much left in this dig site. I know we're mating on the Meteorca. I hope we're not mating on the Meteorca Camphosaurus. What I need to do is have a quick little look at what we are waiting on. So we've got all the small herbivores, large herbivore, waiting on Triceratops, but that's a different dig site, so we're waiting on that for the fossil market. All the other large herbivores, we're waiting on that, we're working on that right now. Velociraptor we're waiting on, but that's a different dig site, that's back in the Flaming Cliffs. Large carnivore, we're waiting on. Acrocamphosaurus, also a different dig site. So I believe it's only Meteocamphosaurus. Okay. I'm not saying anything. I'm not. More food. None of the others have this problem. Actually, you all have this problem. Why aren't you eating? I'm going to put more feeders in. This one might need another feeder, admittedly. There we go. But you've got to understand from my... Like, I always have people saying, oh, you don't need herbivore feeders in herbivore exhibits, because they just eat the grass and stuff. And, like, that makes sense. And then the old Dire Starvation. This is a problem. There's never any sync between the advice between people. He's fine anyway. She's fine. She's up. Oh, crikey. Let's move on anyway. What are we doing today? Well, I want this Momentosaurus thing. What I'm thinking is we're going to pull out of Judith River Group A. Not completely. I'm going to just lower that one. We're going to send some back to the Flaming Cliffs. Because I thought I had two. I do not. I think if we spread out a bit, we'll get less DNA in terms of speed, but all at once we'd get quite a lot from different places. I need to go for the Triceratops, we need to go for the Velociraptor, we need to go for the Indominus Rex, we need to go for the Acrocanthosaurus. But at the moment, we're not really getting much, it must be said. So I'm thinking we might have to rely on the fossil market. So with that said, forget what I said about 2 seconds ago. We'll keep that one because it's good. We'll keep that one because it's average. And we're going to go send two into Morrison Formation A, the final dig site. Let's just put both in there. Can I buy another team? No. 320,000. It's my fault. I said it's a double every time. Now, obviously, our... loads of people have asked how you have it so you can have unlimited buildings and stuff like that. I'm not going to explain it in this video. I think I've already explained it in my past videos. But if you just go and Google it... Why have you had a seizure? Why are you hungry? I promise you there's food. I can hear the goat. Already. I can literally hear it. Look, there's a goat right there. Anyways. Look at that goat. The cocky thing is just sitting there like, yeah, the Velociraptors don't want to eat me. They'd rather die than eat me. I am the king of the goats. Anyways. What was I on about? I can't bloody remember now. I actually can't remember at all. We can build a Metrocamphosaurus. Where is that going to go? I think we might do a little sauropod safari thing down here. Not huge. I need to use the safari car for something. You know, it has to go into the park, right? There's no way we can't have the Jurassic World Safari. But it's not going to be huge because we don't really have the room. So I'm thinking this area down here, and we can put the herbivores we've not had yet in there. So Triceratops can go in there. Momentosaurus can go in there. Whatever we get from this new place can go in there. Stuff like that. Just some cool little things. Dino Rampage! Who is shocked? Nobody is shocked, is it? These guys? These guys don't get along that well. Which is fair enough, really. T-Rex is fine. Mosasaurus is fine. Got Carodontosaurus completely on his own. Still needs water. God knows why. But he's a little pissed off. Now, somebody suggested I sedate. And then revive. Ankylosaurus! Awesome. Big fan. How are we doing? What an amazing result! You have successfully raised the rating up to 5 stars. Jurassic World is now the greatest theme park in the world. Look, buddy. Jurassic World was the greatest theme park in the world, like, as soon as I had one dinosaur in it, frankly. So, you're right, buddy. Don't worry, I'm gonna knock you out and then wake up instantly. This is the worst nap in the world. What's going on over here? I think I might need... What I'm gonna do, I think there's so much water here. We're gonna flatten it up a little bit. Well, what if they would get out of the way? And then a little bit of water, just to make it look a little less daft. I'll do. And let's get some trees in there. Some nice paleo trees. I want them all to be happy, and that's why I really do appreciate the advice that you guys give me all the time. It's just... Sometimes it's not correct. It's, you know, you can't all be right all the time. I've definitely made mistakes, and I've been wrong several times and such. Yes! This is what we needed, right. Ceratosaurus, that's new. Stegosaurus, also new. Right, they're giving me all the, like... I don't need any of these. I want ones from dinosaurs from other dig sites. But what we can do is spot target the dig sites at the end. Once we finish with this one, Stegosaurus, Ankylosaurus, Triceratops, Momentosaurus, that's going to be a cool safari zone. But once we finish with this, we can, send our dig teams off to, like, get specific dinosaurs, basically. We can Now build the sentry turret. That's near enough everything. Two left. Two left. I think we're just gonna focus in. Oh, bloody hell. Well, that's still good. I'll keep that one going. Okie dokie. Cool beans. Cool. Cool. Boo. Boo. Why? Why? What's wrong? Why are you thirsty? You're in a river! Can you please just understand how this is not my fault? Look, there's a goat there. There's a goat there. And they both collapsed because of no water. But they're in a river. They are literally... Look how much water they have. It's ridiculous. What do you want from me, game? It's not even connected to the sea. Somebody suggested last season that if the river was connected to the sea, it's salt water, so the dinosaurs can't drink it. No! There's nothing wrong. They're just crazy. I'm going insane. I think I've actually broken down mentally. My Gallimimus has died. That, I'm hoping, was this Gallimimus. Okay, Poppet, okay. Apparently, you need water as well. Never mind. That there, that's fine. Whatever. Sedate. I think that's actually the main problem. They seem to have a big problem with just drinking. That seems to be a big issue. They're just completely ignoring it. I hope that's not over here. No, it's fine. They're fine. See, they're drinking. Look at that. Gallimimuses. Yeah, they know what's up. They know how to survive. So proud of you guys. You're my little Gallimimus. You're my little Gallimimus. Right. Oh, we just got Velociraptor. Okay. We're going to put it down here. We've got a little bit of space. We may as well use it for something. Nothing else is going to go here. Why not have a little raptor exhibit? Nothing in particularly special for the raptors. Can't think of anything. Oh god, what am I doing? Come on, best and slot. I can't think of anything particularly. I'm going to have to make some land here, aren't I? What would I do for the raptors? I really can't think. Oh, make this bigger. Yeah, look at that. Bam. 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 I quite like that, actually. I like this little island, man-made island that stretches out to sea. I'll knock it in a little bit so it looks a little less daft. As per usual, maybe have some water there. That's quite cool. I quite like that. Stegosaurus! Oh my god, we've got DNA for days, son. DNA for days. Ceratosaurus. Excited about Ceratosaurus, actually, must be said. Right. I'm just trying to think. Raptors. I'm going to put a lot of trees in. I'd like really, like, long grass to try and recreate the Lost World. What I'm thinking is there an amenity I can put in? I just don't think it's going to look right. I was thinking maybe trying to recreate Lost World, but more of the visitor center with the raptors. And the problem is I can't put this in, because if I put it in, people will use it to enter the park. And basically, people are going to fly in and get eaten alive by raptors, which is fine for the final episode of the series. But it's not fine for this episode. So I think we're just going to go nice and calm. Lots of paleo trees. Which I think is going to look pretty cool. It's going to be very difficult to see the little buggers, but... it's going to look pretty cool, and we'll have like a little oasis. Ish in the middle. Raptors! Ladies and gentlemen, Velociraptor. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I'm not going to give them food. I'm going to put lots of little herbivores in instead. And I'm not going to do that because I've just realised I'm pretty poor. So we need a carnivore feeder. It just kind of ruins the feel of it, you know? That's not that big a deal. And the music's going to get really intense and angry, and I love it. Get a couple of these in, lovely jubbly. We're not going to put a dome in just because I do want to try to make it feel a little bit like a forest. Stegosaurus is doing really well. Actually, it's all lows though, isn't it? Go, little raptor, go! Oh, you look cool. Damn! Yeah! Who's my little baby? You're my little baby. Bomb, bomb, bomb. Cool. I do love that first hunt, because they're not hunting for food. They're hunting because they're born and they have the need to kill something. That's awesome. Now it's running around in circles chasing its own tail just to make me kind of undermine the awesomeness. Now it's just a stupid dog. Whatever, that's fine. Whatever. I don't have anything to add to that. Goat. Plenty of goats. We're fine. Okay. So people come down here if they want. It's not that far from... Oh, it's actually quite a trek. Obviously, people aren't going to really walk down this end. I don't really care if people don't see the raptor. It's for us, you know. We're 5 stars. We've got cash. Viewers, the visitors themselves, just don't matter that much. Why did you fall over? Nothing attacked you. You just fell. Oh, you're so dumb. Dilophosaurus is fine. Tyrannosaurus has fainted. Despite having great stats. Thinking the rampage might have been the Rex, and it's collapsed since. I'm gonna put a little water over here. I'm just a little worried that they're too dumb to realize that there's a lake here. So if I put some water there, why are you thirsty? Look, Delta, buddy, pal, look at it. It's a pond. It's right there. Go. I will knock you out and drop you in the pond if I have to. I swear to God. Needs food. Needs water. Why do you need water? You're in a river! Food there. I'm gonna put more food in just in case, but I don't really see it being an issue. Alonzi! There we go. Phosaurus. Dryosaurus. Oh, cool. That's what we're hoping for. Dryosaurus as well, because I don't actually remember where that's from. It's all a little low though. All the DNAs are like little bit of thin, thin, little baby DNAs. And I want big DNAs, manly DNAs, you know? Okay, so what we should do, I suppose, is start building this exhibit over here. We're going to low security wall. And I'm going to land it up a little bit. How big's that? I need to make sure there's enough room for everything else, which is my main worry right now. But that should be big enough. It's not going to be huge. Safari Zone, but it'll be pretty cool. I'm thinking I'd rather have like a lake in the middle. Where's the middle? There's the middle. Like a meeting point in the center where all the dinosaurs go to hang out. Because that's cool. Okay. Attractions! Jurassic World Safari. There we go. Cool! Now, one of the changes we've... Oh, I was meant to say, yeah, if you want to change the number of buildings and paths you can have, because look, we've got 9 kilometers, which is way more than usual. It's really easy to do. You have to edit things called constant.ini. That's the main file. Honestly, there's tons and tons of guides online how to do it. Oh, cool. Tons and tons and tons of guides online if you want to go check out yourself exactly how to do that. I think I did explain it as well in my Jurassic Park Operation Genesis modding video. If you search for Jurassic Park Operation Genesis modding, best in slot, that'll definitely show up as well. And that should be able to help you guys out who are having a little bit of trouble. This mod, you don't need to understand. Somebody mentioned they don't understand Brazilian, so they can't understand it. I promise you, I don't speak Brazilian. You don't need to. Just go on. The download link is very easy to understand. And then you just install it and load it up. It actually functions as a separate game. Kind of thing. You don't load Jurassic Park Operation Genesis, you load JWBP. Super, super easy. Super. If I can do it, you guys can do it. Let's put it that way. I have faith in you all. Can you tell I'm trying to be nice because I feel like I was too mean to you in the video? I do. I feel bad. I think I was a little bit harsh. But it gets to me. Like, we're human, you know, at the end of the day. Like, behind these videos, we're just people just playing games, trying to keep you guys entertained, and sometimes it gets a little irritating when people keep giving you advice without actually, I think, knowing the answer. It's kind of just assuming I'm wrong, basically. You're not hungry. I'm sorry, buddy. You're just not. No problem. Why? Like, I can see goats. I can see two already. Are you a different one? Have you fainted as well? Why are they all fainting? I don't get it. Look, there's clearly food. There's a goat right there. There's a goat right there. Is it my fault they're not killing the goats? I don't think so. Why do you need water? You've collapsed in a river. You should be drowning right now. Ah, whatever. Did I get the same one twice? I'm a little worried. No, I think I got it right. I think we're golden. Okay, that's going to look really cool. We'll have a little hatchery in. We will get rid of the hatchery when we're finished putting the dinosaurs in. We're going to have some feeders just in case. Just need to kind of space them out. Spend some bale right now. So this is going to be Triceratops, Mementosaurus, not Dryosaurus. I want Dryosaurus to go somewhere with little dinosaurs. Dryosaurus is probably going to go hang out with the Gallimimus and the Microceratus in here. And there's one other that I've got. Oh, Ankylosaurus as well. So they're all going to go in here. It's going to be a really, really cool little safari adventure. And because most of the park is now done, what we can also put in is the balloon ride. I'm hoping I can stick it here. So if we just flatten this a little bit. There we go, lovely jubbly. Right, same with the balloon. You'll notice we have 9 kilometers, which is definitely more than usual. And you're gonna head straight. Where's the T-Rex? T-Rex should be last, let's be honest. Right, so T-Rex is there. So you go forward to the left. And up there and down here. Where are we? I'm gonna head down. There. Now, the problem is, they're not all quite in yet. So we want to go over here, because there will definitely be dinosaurs over here at some point. And you don't need to just be a straight circle pattern, do you? You want a little bit of excitement in there. That's going to go all the way down here. Then to the right, and then this will curl round. Up this way, no reason to go over the hill. To the right, through the beautiful, right around the Mosasaurus paddock, like so, and then up to finish on the T-Rex. Lovely. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Dr. Wu, you need more research. This is the final piece of research in the game. I think. Yep. The only one that gets added is the lethal gene, and we get that. Metrocamphosaurus. I'm very confused about this Metrocamphosaurus. Why am I confused? Oh, Mementosaurus. What am I thinking of? What's the Metrocamphosaurus look like? Oh. Hello. You're awesome. I'm a big fan of your work. It looks like the Ceratosaurus, so I'm hoping maybe we can stick those two together, because we really do need to worry about the room. Stegosaurus, awesome. Stegosaurus, awesome. Ceratosaurus, awesome. Got some cool stuff coming on the way, we really do. But, more importantly, this episode, we got, like, the creatures that, I mean, okay, maybe it's not technically a Velociraptor in Jurassic Park, or whatever, but the fact is, the raptors for a lot of us were the dinosaurs. More than a T-Rex, more than a Spinosaurus, the raptors were the dinosaurs of Jurassic Park, and I love the guys. That noise, that I can't do that. That it's kind of close. That noise, just, it's like, it is so much of Jurassic Park to me. It really is, and they were by far the best part of the Lost World as well. So amazing. They're just gonna tell me I'm incredible all the time, which I'm okay with. Oh no, we got disease. Off we got rabies species. Because these are quite early in the dinosaur. Oh, now you're being all angry about it. Look, I'm trying to cure you, buddy. I've got to admit, I'm kind of impressed. The pteranodons have been okay for like the entire thing. Claire, did I just? Oh, she was okay. I thought she was in. She's fine. She was in the viewing dome. She was in the viewing dome. We're okay. Hello. You're going balls to the wall, are you? She probably sedate you. Come here, buddy. Dino attack, dino attack. I think that might be, how old was the Suchomimus? 2 years, I was gonna say, I think that might be the first time we've lost a Suchomimus. Baryonyx has gone once, I think. Spinosaurus has gone like 5 times. Suchomimus has been a tough old bird. very close to Dryosaurus. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to end it there. I'm sorry for blowing up a little bit at you, but sometimes you need to get stuff off your chest. Sometimes we need to just chill and talk and bants or something. We've got ourselves some new Velociraptors, and they are pretty bloody cool. Next episode, we're working on Mementiosaurus. We're working on Stegosaurus, Metrorhynchus. Is that a thing I just said? I don't know. Triceratops, loads of cool stuff to go. We're going to finish off the little safari exhibit. We need to add, I think, 3 more carnivores, Indominus and the 2 new ones, Ceratosaurus, Metri. Is that it? Tell you what, we're in the end game. Yeah. Thank you. I appreciate all the comments. I'm worried now. I want to get that across. I really appreciate all the comments, even if it's a negative comment. I kind of appreciate it because it's good for my search results. But it's just nice to know people are watching and they care enough to comment and offer advice and stuff. I just like to suggest that I do kind of know what I'm doing to an extent, and that I don't. I promise it is a bug. It's nothing to do with the exhibits. It's the Dimorphodons in particular were just crazy. They really were, and I really do not believe it was something wrong on my part. But regardless of that, I appreciate the comments, and I love you all. Please forgive me. Thank you for joining me. Cheers. Much love, as always. Bye-bye.